him with the timbrel and dance. Praise him with the sound of the trumpet. Praise him with the psaltery and harp. Let every demon have breath. Praise the Lord. Praise him with timbrel and dance. Praise him on the high sounding cymbals. Praise him in the stringed instruments. Let every demon have breath. Praise the Lord.
Oh, magnify the Lord. Magnify the Lord.
Praise him with the sound of the trumpet. Praise him with the psaltery and harp. Let everything that hath breath praise the Lord.
Praise him
with timbrel and dance.
Praise him
on the high sounding
cymbals. Praise him
with string instruments. Let everything that hath breath praise the Lord.
Oh, magnify the Lord. Magnify the Lord with me. Magnify the Lord. Oh, magnify the Lord.
All you people, all be joyful and clap your hands. All be joyful, all you people, all be joyful and clap your hands. All be joyful, all you people, all be joyful and clap your hands. All be joyful,
all you people,
all be joyful and clap your hands.
All be joyful, all you people,
all be joyful and clap your hands.
All be joyful,
all you people, all be joyful and clap your hands.
All be joyful,
all you people, all be joyful and clap your hands.
Somebody help me lift him up.
Lift him
up. He's worthy of the praise.
Lift him
up. He's worthy of the honor.
Lift him up.
Magnify his name.
Lift him up.
Lift your hands to heaven.
Lift
him up. He's worthy to be glorified.
Lift him up.
He is the King.
Lift him up.
Oh, yes, he is.
Lift him up. Lift him up. Lift him up. Lift him up. Lift him up.
To be magnified today. Is he worthy to be glorified? Come on, magnify him because he is the King.
Lift him up.
Lift him up. He is the King. Yes, he is. Come on and praise him.
Lift him up.
He is Jehovah Jireh. My ultimate provider.
Lift him up.
Yes, he is.
Lift him up.
Come on, help me sing.
Lift him up. 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 Lift him up.
worship as they do. And we worship you alone with a song of praise.
Oh,
one day before your throne, this is the noise we made.
I need to hear some saints of God making some noise in the building this morning. Shout now. This is our Lord.
This is the noise we make with our voice and with our hand. We've come to celebrate all across the land. Hey, hey.
Come on, shout now, church. Shout. The joy.
The joy that's in our hearts makes us want to dance for you. Join as the angels sing and worship as they do. And we worship you alone with the songs of praise.
Oh,
one day before your throne, this is the noise we make.
Oh, hallelujah. Jesus, we lift you high this morning. You're glorious. You're worthy. You are worthy. For the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Come on, put your hands together.
You are worthy, you are worthy, worthy, you are holy, holy, you are holy, holy,
you are. Come on, get your hands up, church. Magnify Jesus. He's worthy of all the praise and all the honor. Oh, hallelujah. Say, oh, magnify the Lord.
Oh, magnify the Lord with me.
Let us exalt
his name together. Enter into the house of the Lord.
our praise this morning. Yes, you are. We just lift you up today. Hallelujah. God, you're worthy. Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh, God, we thank you for your healing power today at work in this place. We thank you, Lord, for your anointing that will be present this week. You may be seated in his presence. Keep this atmosphere of worship and praise.
Praise you, Jesus. We read in the Word of God where he said, he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes we were healed. You may be here this morning, broken in spirit, broken in body. Let this song minister to you.
If your heart is broken and your spirit wounded, and you feel that there's no one there for you, have your troubles cost you tears, pain, doubt, and fear, and you feel that you've done all that you can do, then just be healed. Yes, yes,
be healed.
Jesus said, arise, take up your bed, and go on to do his will.
Be healed.
Oh, let his blood
Stand with me, please, all across the building. Once again, we want to thank you for being with us at Dominion Camp Meeting, and I want to introduce to you someone who is known internationally for his apostolic authority, someone who is known across this country for his prophetic vision. But I believe that those of us here at World Harvest Church in Columbus, Ohio, have an advantage above all of them because we know him as pastor. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome to this platform the host of Dominion Camp Meeting, Pastor Rob Parson.
Come on now, you fought a lot of devils to get here. And every one of them lays at your feet, bleeding and defeated. Because greater is he that is in you than he that is in this world. He's given you power over all devils and cure diseases, and nothing shall by any means harm you. Just tell somebody next to you, go ahead and tell them, excuse me. Excuse me. Don't say excuse me. That's why you say it when you're not anointed. Say, the word starts with S. Excuse me. But you might want to give me just a little bit of room, cause I feel a praise coming on up in here. You'll excuse my shout and excuse my wave and excuse my dance and excuse me if I shout the hairpins out of my hair, because you don't know like I know what he's done for me to get me right where I am, and I have been strategically positioned. Venture to the verge, encounter the edge, brought to the brink of my miracle, and I'm not leaving here like I came. Throw both hands up and thank the God that is going to make it all possible. Oh, it's good, you know. It's good to be at camp meeting. I like camp meeting. Hello, Bill. It's wonderful to see you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You don't know Bill. I know Bill. I know Bill 15 years in a wheelchair. I'm not talking about somebody who, you know, didn't feel like walking in the building, so somebody rolled him in. I'm talking about a man been in a wheelchair 15 years. Hit by a locomotive on a motorcycle. 39 prescribed medications a day. Had to be lifted out of the wheelchair and put in the bed. Completely paralyzed from his waist down. Talk about Bill. Talk about Bill. Tomorrow night, I may be talking about you after this morning. Oh, I felt that right there. Woo, somebody came expecting somebody. Somebody didn't show up to see what God was going to do for somebody else. Somebody came to get their own miracle. Bill. Blind in one eye, Bill. Sugar level over 400, Bill. 3 insulin shots a day, Bill. 39 prescribed medications a day, Bill. Demerol, Dalming, Dilaudid, Valium, Percocet, Percodan. Bill. Yeah.
seeing eye dog Bill. November a year ago, Bill got rolled up on this platform, but he walked off this platform and he not been back in a wheelchair since. He not even had an aspirin tablet in a year and a half. Sugar level perfectly normal. I'm talking about that's a kind of miracle working power of God available to you this week. I want to see a hand lifted up of everybody believes you're going to get yours. You may be seated. Oh, I got to hurry. I'm always in a hurry. I like camp meeting. Come here, sir. You right there, come here. Come here. Come here, I got something for you. Before 40 days, the miracle shall break forth and the darkness shall be dissipated. The glory of God shall rest upon you, and you shall never look back after this day, says the Lord. Yeah, somebody give him glory. I'm talking about Holy Ghost now. Don't you come in here and act like we're going to have some other kind of camp meeting. This is not the place to be cute. This is not the place to be pretty. This is the place to sweat your estelada off in a praise that hell can't turn the tide of. Sit down now. I don't get to preach today. I got to preach tonight. I'm going to talk tonight about a God of more than enough. I'm tired of you running around trying to use your faith just to get a need met. He's not a need meeting God. He'll break through your need into the realm of the supernatural and do exceeding abundantly above all that you could ever even ask a thing. Sit down, I preach tonight. I preach tonight. Camp meeting is good. The first camp meeting was called the Feast of Tabernacles, where everybody would come away out of their homes and out of their businesses, and regardless of how high they'd climbed on the corporate or ministry ladder, camp meeting, Tabernacles was the great equalizer. Everybody forgot who they were and what their credentials were or were not. And they came and dwelt in tents. They had to leave their mansion or their shack. And everybody just got underneath the tent. Hallelujah. And that's where you are. Here's my suggestion to you. Forget your name. If you're Bishop so-and-so, just become Bob. God looking for Bob. He don't need a bishop. He just wants to do a work in you. And you in here lost in this crowd, right where God can get deep inside you. Forget who you are. Forget where you came from. Forget what's waiting back there. Wade on out into the overflowing, overthrowing supernatural presence of the Lord. Get everything you came for and more beside. Not one leaves disappointed. Everybody leaves with every prayer answered. You might as well give him a praise right now. I got a feeling your miracle's waiting on the door when you get back home. I can't. Do you have a Bible? Do you have a Bible? The right Bible. Hold it up if you got the right Bible. Look at that. Your choir better have the right Bible. Breakthrough Covenant Partner Devotional Bible. If you don't have one, you can get one in some of these foyers around here. Hasn't this staff done a remarkable job in preparation for your arrival? I'm on page 35. In the right Bible, in the beginning, not the 35 New Testament, not the 35 Old Covenant, but 35 right there in the middle, some stuff I wrote. For the rest of you, I can't help you. page 35. Proverbs 13:22. The wealth of the sinner. Now, just touch somebody and say they got a lot of it. Have you noticed that their greed is getting them in trouble? From Enron to WorldCom. The financial systems of this world are in utter chaos. WorldCom, bless their hearts, poor Arthur Anderson. Poor Arthur Anderson and WorldCom have misplaced $3 billion. I asked the Lord about that. I said, what in the world, smart, intelligent, college-educated men can lose $3 billion? If I've lost 30 cents, it drives me crazy until I find it. They've lost $3 billion. I said, God, how's that possible? He said, they didn't lose it. I moved it. I'm telling you what the Holy Ghost said. Holy Ghost said, they didn't lose it. I moved it. The wealth of the sinner finds its way eventually into the hands of the righteous. Just do this. Woo! For whom it has been laid up. Glory to God. I believe the Lord is supernaturally getting ready to open the windows of heaven. Now, that doesn't mean he's going to pour out money. Because what you need is not money. What you need is a revelation. The money's already there. You just got to know how to find it. The Holy Spirit is preparing a shower of blessing for your life. Shout staggering blessing. Overwhelming blessing. Overflowing blessing. Overthrowing blessing. Be coming in here looking to get some little dab of do you blessing. Some of you already had enough oil put on you. You look like a grease pig at a county fair, and it hadn't done you a bit of good. God is about to move you into staggering. I can't stand up under it. Bless it. And I believe you're destined to come out. I thought if I read this, I'd slow down some. To come. Destined to come out of financial bondage where reapers are about to overtake sowers. 3 John 2 says, beloved, I wish above all things that thou mayest prosper and be in health. But you got to read the whole verse. As your soul prospers. What is your soul? God's three parts, Father, Son, Holy Ghost, inner court, outer court, Holy of Holies. Gabriel, Lucifer, Michael, everything in threes. Spirit, soul, body. Man is a spirit, possesses a soul, and lives in a body. I can say that because it was my pastor that brought the body of Christ that revelation. Until he wallowed around in Manila in the Philippines and begged God to give it to him, people were calling all over the country the spirit and the soul the same thing. But they're not the same thing. And so my pastor, on a 40-day fast, went before the Lord and said, what is the difference in the spirit and the soul? And God showed him. The soul is the mind, the will, and the emotions. So if you're going to prosper in your soul, you first of all have to have a mind that's renewed to what this said about you, not what the Dow Jones said about you. You have to have a will. Now watch this now. Don't get religious in here. This is Dominion Camp meeting. I said, this is Dominion Camp meeting. Not talking about a broken will. God don't want to. I spent many, many years of my life in a denomination where all they preached to me was that God wanted to break my will. And finally, I asked the Lord, what good is a broken will? And God said, I don't want it broken. I want it submitted. I ain't going to get one bit of help in here today. You're just waiting on Judy Jacobs. I know that. A will that is submitted. Can you believe you have to convince people to submit to prosperity? I was in a restaurant the other day and a fellow came up to me talking real loud. Oh, Brother Rod Parsley. Yeah, well, I had on my sunglasses and ball cap and he knew me anyhow. Because I opened my big mouth and started talking. And he recognized my voice. He said, don't you believe in a vow of poverty? I said, absolutely I do. For the devil. Why would I believe in the vow of poverty? I looked right back at him. I said, do you believe it's God's will for the Church of Jesus Christ to feed the poor around the world? Do you believe it's God's will that I go to Sudan and break the chains of 15,000 black brothers and sisters who are in chains in Sudan? Do you believe it's God's will I go set them free? Oh, absolutely. I said, well, it cost me $1 million to do it. A will that is submitted, a mind that is renewed, and emotions, watch me, that do not control you, but emotions that are controlling. You see, you're not supposed to be a thermometer. You're supposed to be a thermostat. You're not supposed to react to the temperature. You're supposed to set it. I said hallelujah. And I asked the Lord. I can't read no more. I'll preach all morning. I said, there's another page and a half in there if you want to read it later. I said to the Lord, why is it that you have saved the revelation of financial prosperity? Hello, Dr. Ball. It's nice to see you. Of financial prosperity until now. Why has it been closed up, sealed up in a book? And God said the most wonderful thing to me. He said, revelation given to the first generation is just that, a conviction, a revelation. The second generation given that revelation will walk in that revelation. But by the third generation, they will institutionalize that revelation. They'll build a denominational wall around it. They'll start saying, well, it has to be this way and not that way. And they strip it of its power. Are you getting anything? If you don't believe that, look at Pentecost. It came like a mighty rushing wind in that visitation at Azusa Street. The second generation walked in it. They didn't care what the news media thought about it. If God said roll in the middle of the sawdust trail, they'd roll. If God said shout, they'd shout. If God said run, they'd run. And they sure wouldn't edit out speaking in tongues from their television audience. But now the third generation, they built great denominations around it. I could name some for you. And they cornered the market on it. And now you can barely find it. We've become charismaniacs, not Pentecostals. God help us. And he said the same thing by the fourth generation, that truth is lost altogether. And God said the same thing is true of financial wealth. If I had given it those generations ago, by now, when I need it to preach this gospel to the four-flung corners of the world, the revelation would have already been lost. He said, this ain't going to happen fast and furious. A great transfer of wealth out of the hands of the wicked into the hands of the just for the preaching of the gospel. And God doesn't care one little bit about it rubbing off on you on the way. Just touch somebody and say, he's not just a need meter. He's a God of overflow, of abundance. Hallelujah. Now close your Bible. Close your Bible and grab an offering envelope. Let's give action to your faith this morning at the beginning of this great camp meeting. This is not a time to hold back. This is a time to let go and let God. If you need an offering envelope, they can be found in the pew in front of you. If you're giving by check this morning, simply put a WHC on your check. That's all you need. If you've made it out some other way, that's all right. If you've made it out to Harold Woodson, that's fine. I'll cash it. It doesn't matter. Just fill it out completely. WHC, World Harvest Church, Breakthrough, whatever you want to put on there, it's all the same, and it'll bring great blessing. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Somebody asked me the other day, what is the budget of this meeting? I have no earthly idea. Why would I want my faith to be hindered? The budget is whatever we need to do it. And God will take care of those needs, and we're so thankful and grateful for it. He's a great God. Father, bless this offering. Let it be an offering that opens the windows of heaven. Let it be the key and the door to our blessing. Let our act of obedience be greater than the sacrifice. Loose your people from the bondages of financial debt and lack. Bring us into the land of plenty. Thereby we'll bless your kingdom, and hell's gates will be destroyed. In the name of Jesus, we thank you for it. Amen. Amen. Are you ready to sow your seeds of faith? Always sow them toward a need. These three young ladies are going to come and bless you. Tell them you appreciate them very much.
Mountains are gonna run. He will never.
I'm so thankful for the relationships and friendships that God has brought into my life over the past 24 and a half years. There's one thing I've always been able to do. Let's enjoy talent, but recognize anointing. And I have rarely witnessed the combination of spiritual aptitude and maturity, revelation and theological stability become the springboard of such tremendous talent, which produces an incredible anointing as that of Judy Jacobs. I'm so thankful for folk that didn't burn out in the world and lose their record contract and then try to come to the church and see what they could do. Some of them, God put his hand of on in their mama's belly. This one, this morning, the youngest of 12 children. What an anointing. What a blessing. How overwhelmingly proud I am to have Judy Jacobs grace the platform of World Harvest Church and Dominion Camp Meeting. Would you welcome her, please? It's Judy Jacobs.
We bless you, Father. You're in this room today. And in the beginning of this camp meeting, this glorious week, we take authority over in the name of Jesus, and we say every fetter will be broken in lives. We thank you because we're going to push into you this week. Lord, our desire is that you would give us a heart of worship. Let our lives have this treasure in earthen vessels. The excellency of the power may be of you, God, and not us. Lord, give us a heart like David, who was known as a man after God's own heart. He stated in Psalms, I long for you, Jesus. I'm running out. You're watching over me with your arms open wide. There's no place I can hide. You are my heart's desire. There's everlasting joy.
You're greater than the grave.
right now, today, June the 30th, we find our hope. Thank God there is healing, 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 healing. Your love is deeper than the deep. God, so strong, strong, strong. In you, I can find some peace. I can hide. You, nobody else can do Jesus. You are my heart's desire. All the praise and all the glory, because you are so worthy. You deserve the glory and the honor. Come on, church. We lift our hands in worship as we lift your holy name. You deserve the glory and all the honor. As we lift your holy name, for you are great, you do miracles so great, there is no one else like you. That's right, come on. There is no one else like you. You are great, you do
my healer, my keeper.
You're my deliverer. Hallelujah. Yeah. Why don't you shout like you know he is? You say you don't know what I've been through, but I know about Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. I said he's your deliverer. Turn to somebody and say, she's talking about me. Now you've got to shout like you know he's talking about you.
Declaring the word of the Lord. And these are the days of your servant Moses, righteousness being restored. And though these are days of great trial, of famine and darkness and sword, still we are the voice in the desert, crying, prepare ye the way of the Lord. Behold, he comes, yes, riding on the cloud. Hey, shining like the sun at the trumpet call. So lift your voice. It's the year of Jubilee.
Yes, it is.
Out of Zion's hill, salvation comes.
Hey, yeah. Yes, God.
Days of Ezekiel, the dry bones becoming his flesh. And these are the days of your servant David, rebuilding a temple of praise.
Praise him in his house right now.
These are the days of the harvest. Fields are as white in your world.
Yes, and we.
The laborers in your vineyard, and we're declaring the word of the Lord. Behold, he comes,
hey,
riding on a cloud, shining like the sun at the trumpet call. So lift your voice, it's the year of Jubilee.
Yes, it is.
Out of Zion's hill, salvation.
Behold, it comes.
Behold, he comes.
Yes,
riding on a cloud,
hey,
shining like the sun at the trumpet call.
Lift your hands. Let's declare him to be who he is. Say it.
There's no God like Jehovah.
Come on.
There's no God like Jehovah.
Yeah.
There's no God like Jehovah. 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 There's no God like Jehovah.
There's no God like Jehovah.
No, no.
There's no God like Jehovah.
Nobody.
There's no God like Jehovah.
Nobody.
There's no God like Jehovah.
Nobody, nobody. Nobody, nobody, nobody. Nobody like Jesus. Like Jesus. Yeah.
And the Holy Ghost. She'll be back tonight. I want you to lift up your hands and give Jehovah praise. Come on, the atmosphere of expectancy becomes the breeding ground for your miracle. God's servant is in this house this morning. I reserve Sunday morning of Dominion Camp Meeting. actually for the person that I believe has been greatest used by the Holy Spirit over the past year in a service in this local congregation. Brother Ted Shuttlesworth came to us a few months ago, like John, out of the wilderness, eating locusts and wild honey, crying loud and sparing not. Pinpoint accuracy in the gifts of the Holy Ghost. A seer. Hallelujah. So much so that the next day we canceled classes at World Harvest Bible College and canceled classes at Harvest Preparatory School. And I wanted those first graders and second graders and fifth graders to see a man move in the gifts of the Holy Ghost. We had seventh graders walking around the hallway saying, that was better than Star Wars. How did that man know all that stuff? And other children say, well, that's the gifts of the Holy Ghost. Let me lay hands on you and you can get it. That's the man we love to bring to Dominion Camp Meeting. Bonnie, his wife, is with him today. Megan, their daughter, and Ted Jr. We're delighted to have them all here. Can't wait for him to grace this pulpit, open up his spirit to the Holy Ghost, and let God be God. Would you welcome Brother Ted Shuttlesworth to Dominion Camp Meeting?
Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God. Come on, lift your hands and just worship him for a moment. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Well, oh, we love you, Lord. We praise you, Jesus. Ramashilamando Korabahayanda Kisalamando. Hallelujah. 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 Just lift your hands on this opening service. I believe God is already touching us from what we've already heard, received. Press in. We just get a little closer, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah, Jesus. Praise thy name, Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise thy name, Lord. Glory. Hallelujah. Praise thy name, Lord. Hallelujah. Well, oh, it is Jesus. Sing wonderful. Yes, it is Jesus in my soul. Well, for I have touched the hem of his garment, and his blood has made me whole. lift your hand and sing it again. Everybody. Well, oh, it's
Jesus.
Sing it now. Come on.
Wonderful Jesus.
Yes, it's Jesus. Thank God for that blood. Thank God for that blood. Hallelujah. Before you're seated, turn around and tell somebody this will be the best camp meeting ever in Jesus' name. Praise God. Hallelujah. Glory. Glory. Jesus. Praise God. I was upstairs in my ministry offices when someone said, Pastor Parsley's secretary has called and wants to know if you'll come to camp meeting. I said, I'm not falling for that trick going back downstairs. Amen. And then I got a buzz on the intercom, and they said, Sister Joanna is on the phone. And I picked it up, and she said, Brother Parsley would like for you to come and be at the opening service of camp meeting. And I said, I can't come. And when I said that, I was kicking myself, because I honestly thought I was scheduled to be somewhere else. And I've never, canceled one meeting for another one. And after I hung up with her, I thought, Lord, I don't know what you're doing to me, but stop it. I was trying to think of anybody I offended. I was going to call people and repent. Anything I had to do to get back in the will of God, you know. And so I called Chris that does our crusades, and I said, how's that meeting coming in where we were to go? And he said, I haven't heard a word from them. I said, don't call them. I said, you didn't get a fax or an email or nothing on the confirmation? He said, no, sir. I said, pretend like they don't exist till after June the 30th. Then call them and say, where is that stuff? And when I called back, I was very happy to be able to be here. I'm actually very honored. It's a privilege to be here. And we give God the praise for what he's doing. Now, of all the people you got this week, I'll guarantee you I'm the only one that I'm wondering about. Amen. The rest, I know God's got his hand on every life, and we thank God for him. Can you say amen? Amen. If you have your Bible, I want you to turn to Isaiah chapter 10. I don't intend to be too long. I figure I can say what I got to say in a couple of hours. Amen. Brother Woodson just passed out. Revive him. You love the Lord today? I tried to fast and pray, and I set the whole week aside. And the Lord really didn't give me anything to say until Friday night at about 10 after 7. Sitting on the couch, I was praying for somebody, and then it all fell in my spirit, what I felt like God had for me to just encourage you. We're living in a day, there's all kinds of bad news all around us, and people are worried and concerned about the future. But some of the things God's going to do this week, He's going to put a stop to the attacks of the devil designed to hinder revival. On May the 9th, Thursday morning, at it was about 10:30 according to the timer on the television camera I was preaching into, the Lord spoke to me, and I prophesied to the people that if the church in America did not begin to pray, that by next year at this time, America would be at her most crucial point. And immediately, we began daily prayers in our office, as well as with our personal life, my wife and I, with a new sense of urgency. But I tell you, there's nothing the devil can do that God can't do something about it. And God's going to have a revival in this world. Can you say praise God? And what the devil is afraid of is he sees the opening up of these Muslim countries to the gospel, and he's trying to distract us. That's all that Pledge of Allegiance thing was. That's a smokescreen of the devil. The judge said the next day, he said, I don't even know why I did it. That's because he wasn't in his right mind when he made it. But I'm not distracted by the devil. We're not ignorant of the devil's devices. Can you say amen? Amen. And Peter Youngren called me 2 days ago, and he's already got fields rented in Afghanistan and some of these Muslim nations, and he's going to go in and hold crusades and preach. He had a Taliban fighter whose son, or excuse me, daughter, who was deaf, a deaf mute, couldn't hear or speak, who came to Peter's meeting in Karachi. And Peter prayed for the man's daughter, and Jesus opened both of her deaf ears, loosed her tongue. Praise God. And the Taliban fighter went back to Afghanistan to tell it, and they burned his house down and drove him out of the village, but he turned into a Holy Ghost preacher, because if Jesus can heal his daughter, Jesus did what Muhammad couldn't do. Hallelujah! Isaiah chapter 10, if you have your Bible, I'm just going to read from one verse of Scripture. Did you enjoy Sister Judy Jacobs today? Brother Parsley was so anointed when he took this mic and he preached and exhorted us, and she was anointed. I leaned over to him and I said, with all of this, I said, I'll see you later. I'm going home. Amen. Isaiah chapter 10, verse 27. The Lord put this in my spirit Friday night. And it shall come to pass. Everybody say, it shall come to pass. And it shall come to pass in that day that his burden shall be taken away from off thy shoulder, and his yoke from off thy neck. And the yoke shall be destroyed because of the anointing. Hallelujah.